Hey guys, it's me, Young Leo Accio here. How you guys doing? Hello, all my Facebook, YouTube, Google Plus fan out there, all my friends. Today is September the 8th, 2016. And I'm just starting out my day this morning. Finished up the door on my Eclipse, 98 Eclipse. Feel like wanted to make this video showing you guys why I'm in the process of installing my driver's side door panels on, as long as going over the trim that I made the video last time. I want to go over a little bit about that too, and you know, the window and the doors out here on the driver's side. The passenger side pretty much going to be the same way, how to install and uninstall the door panels back on. So I'm in the last step of installing the door panel back on before I take it to inspection, but you will need a door panel to go to inspection. And everything is, you know, in place, all the screw and the bolts that belong to the door panel. Let's see, I should start here first. My plastic cover on the door, you know, inside the door interior, has been torn out. This is the old one. As you can see, it's, you know, that's all I have left, just a torn little piece of plastic there with some glue. But I went to the junkyard and got me a new one from a I think from a 99 Eclipse. And I got this plastic from a 99 Eclipse, and you know, it looks pretty much in shape, nothing torn out, so I got it. I think they gave me for free, because I got some, you know, the door hinge that one day, and they I don't think they charged me for this piece of plastic, for the door plastic here. It also have adhesive glue already there from the old vehicle, on this plastic here, as you can see. And you really want to take out all this screw here, all this right here, before you take out the plastic. And also the you want to take out the speaker there. Should have all your wire connection and these kind of plug in place onto the door, for the wires. So all the wire has this little lock connection. You see these with the holes into your door panel. It's look like these kind of holes right here. So you just put, you know, it's just gonna hold your wire in place. That's it. And once everything is in place, you find all the holes to lock it in place. Have this, this is the door, window and lock harness wire. Have this thing out, you know, from this hole right there. Should already have it out for you. The hole should already cut, and just pretty much uninstall, you know, these components out, this door handle and the locks and all that out before you install this plastic back on. So I am done with this part. All my plastic is in place. It might be right because, you know, it's from another door, so, you know, all the glue might not be right for your door. Like my door here, you know, some spot is not right. So just do the best that I can. And the next step is have all your door bolts, locate them, you know where they are. You might want to chain this if yours is bad or torn out. Chain this, because this is where it hoses the the screw when you screw it in through from the door panel right here. Okay, I'll show you in a minute, but these screws should be, you know, should screw into that plastic piece, just like this one. This is the white one, that's the black one. But these, for these holes right here, these are for where you put the door panel on, and those thing is like right here, the holes. This red piece right here, I don't know if you can see it because it's so sunny. this red piece right here meant to be going to that hole, okay? And the red piece going to this. I just install enough, you know, in each corner so I can install my door panel back into the interior of the door, okay? So I kind of, I just put like each corner, you know, those red little screw, I put it like each corner here. But like for this right here, you see that? The more you take in and out of your door panel, this hole right here is gonna get bigger. See, like these kind of hole, it's gonna smash, crack, and get bigger. See that over here? You know, it's almost torn out. And luckily, mine was okay, not so bad. So, so after you install that those red screws, go ahead and install the. I got a little ants crawling on me. It's a big ant. So then, after you have those red screws installed on every corner there, and then just you know, like I told you about this right here, use this kind of screw. You want to use washer with it. So get some washer about this size. The bigger the better, I guess. To kind of you know, so you can when you install the screw through from the door panel onto here, then you have a big washer with your screw, you know, so it can hold it, you know, so it won't torn out. It can hold it, you know, so so your door panel will be in place, okay? That's why I would use like bigger washer like that, so it'll hold against this door panel right here. See? Yeah. Okay, so that's the correct way to do it. I don't know if you can find like some other big bolts or, you know, with some big washer, that'll be better. But try to have it around, just around here only. The washer cannot be bigger than this spot right there. Okay, so, you know, the kind of washer I had is pretty much do the job. So, I just changed this out because it was all cracking. You know, I bought some of these from the junkyard like back in the day, and I still have it. And so I just changed this out. And as you can see, it's a different color. This is the old one right here. See? It's all cracked. So I changed it. See that? Yep. It's pretty easy. I'll show you too. There's two little screws in the back. So just take a Phillips, small Phillips. I would recommend small Phillips to do this job. Around this door panel, just use small Phillips, okay? Don't use big or long one because it'll not work. There's two screws. Just take them out and then take a flat screwdriver. I don't know if you can see it because it's kind of dark here under the tree. Just pry this out. I think there's three locks, you know, just pry, push three locks out, and this piece should come up, okay? Just push it up, it'll come up. My door is kind of old, so some of this thing is kind of not in place. It's kind of crooked or whatever. It's broke, some are broken, like especially these right here, these bolts and knobs right here. They're plastic, so they're easy to break. Just like my, I'll show you another thing. See that? There's some crack too, but if it's not so big, it's not a big problem. Like these lock switch, window switch, this whole component, you know, this is where you plug in your connection onto here, and see that? Okay, and this piece right here, that switch connection piece right here, the power switch, it was loosing, you know. That's why I use one of this what you call metal wire. You see, it's rust now because water been in. But just use a metal wire and kind of wrap around it, tie around this, you see that? Just tie around it in place and tight, and so this piece won't move again. So, you know, I can now press these buttons without having a problem of it's, you know, hanging down or pushing down or saggy or whatever, okay? And this is where the bolts, where you're gonna tighten your, the door handle. So the door handle will be tight, and this is spot right here. See that bolt right there? Yep. When I install the door panel on, I'm gonna screw that bolt in. That's where all the power, when you pull the door in to shut the door, this is where you hold in to shut the door. You see, it has more power when you screw in that screw right there. Okay, so all around this door, you want to install everything like this was hanging out. You know, you want to install everything tight on, nothing hang around, so you can, you know, close shut the door right on. Because when I bought this car, I was having a problem shutting the door, you know, because this thing was hanging out, and you know, the bolt was fine, and this weather strip is fine too. It's not nothing torn out bad or whatever, just some chips here and there. But you know, the most important is have it in place, you know. Don't let it hang out or whatever, you know. And you don't necessarily need to use any silicone or sealing either, because this is the weather strip. You know, you want to, if you want to, you can do it. You can put some glue, some silicone around it, so water won't come in. But it's not gonna be that bad. Okay. I did seal up, as you can see, my door hinge trims. Like I showed you my other video about the door, window and door trim. When I got this from the junkyard and I tore it down, I took out, unscrewed like 15 bolts. You want to use the driller gun when you take out all the bolts, okay? Because that's a lot of bolts. I didn't mention that because my gun was hiding under the seat, and I have this plastic here cover. This plastic is when you cover the plastic up, so when you scrape this, you know, dirt won't fall into your car, okay? It won't fall into the seats and the floor in the car. So you don't have to vacuum that out, you know, but you pretty much do have to vacuum afterward. But it's better because this is a lot of dry glue gonna fall into your car. Okay, so here it is. I put some silicone on. These are actually clear silicone. It's white because it's new, and I hate to see, because it's my experience, when you do this overnight, you want to cover something with it so water won't humidify and contaminate this glue here, because mine is contaminated, so it's not dry yet. It had water in it, so that's a bad thing. I might have to run another beads coat over it too today, and just cover it overnight so, you know, water won't come in. But really, you want to do it when the weather is not raining, you know, when, you know, a week that hasn't rained, that's good when to do it. Do it when you know there's no rain coming up, okay? And also the outside trim. I put some silicone to seal some hole spot there. And you know, just pretty much seal everything else as much as you can with weather strip. Show you my video about this too. It's falling out. This kind of weather strip from low, you know, it's not that good, so it's gonna fall out. Well, one of it is good, you know, one of it is still hanging here. This, like this one, is still in place, but this one, I keep having to put it back on. So, find you a good weather strip, like this kind of weather strip right here, that'll be the best. When you install this weather strip right here, push it really hard. Use your force and wiggle it around so you can install this weather strip in place, because it's hard, you know. You know, just kind of use your force to push it around up and down, you know, over and over, so it'll be tack in place. Okay. Alright guys, so now I'm ready to install my door panel on. And let's see how it is afterward when I make another video, kind of go around my car when I'm done with everything before I inspect it. I still gotta install my front kit right there too. So well, I'm not worried about the minutes, because I can still upload on YouTube even though it's more than 15 minutes. When you clean your windows, see all your tapes around the window? When you have some tape around the window like this, you see, just use a razor to scrape all the old, you know, scrape all of the old tapes, because I have tapes around before, because I'm trying to, you know, tape up my window and all that so water won't come in. But now I'm pretty much done with the ceiling on my door, so I don't really need to tape anymore using tapes. So just use some razor to clean it up. After that, just use some window spray, you know, for window Windex spray and clean it up. Okay. Have your, you know, regular tool like Phillips screwdriver to do install the interior door handle there, or door panel there. So that's basically it. If you break one of these red thing or one of these screw, just get it from the junkyard. I mean, I think Lowe has it too. Lowe has like different size too. So just choose the right side and install it back on. If you're not gonna take your door out again, I recommend install all this back on. And it is gonna be a pain when you take it out too. You have to know where the location of these bolts. After you take out these screw right here, know the location of all this screw and just kind of be easy with it and pry your door out, okay? I don't have that much screw in just the corner because I might have to take out my speaker later on, so you know it'll be easy for me to put just a couple of screws because I know I'll have to take the door panel out after inspection if I'm gonna install my CD player in. Same like the other door, the passenger side door, I will have to do the same thing. Okay, I haven't taken that out yet, but that side looks like it's pretty good. It's just this driver's side, you know, how driver's side door panel, you know, people bang it all the time, so it's losing, you know, it's losing over time. But the passenger side door panel, you know, that side's pretty good, you know. I mean, I just got to install this new on the other side too, because it has a little crack, and I have already got it too. It's right there. Yeah, I put it right there. Yep. And then lastly, I'm gonna have to install this this little cover right here. The other side, I'll show you too. The other side, I got all this from the junkyard, you know. I got it all ready from over the time. Yeah, you should install this on here. That's the cover for the door hinge, whatever you want to call it, door handle. Yeah. So I gotta install this in after, you know, after everything's done. See this crack right here? I'm gonna change it to this. Yep. You pretty much not worry about this if you don't have AC or, you know, you're trying to have air flowing through. But you do want to clean it up if it's dirty. Mine's pretty dirty. So I will have to clean it up over the time after this. And, you know, just install some little stuff, you know, some little parts after I'm done with this, like just like these right here. These, I have tons of it too. I got extra from the junkyard because I have two Eclipse, okay, a 99 and a 98. And this part right here, you install it right here. You know, it go around the corner of the seats. So it makes it look, you know, cover up the seat, you know. But you want to use this when you have carpets, okay? It'll look nice with the carpet too. But you don't necessarily have carpet. Just cover it up so, you know, you won't see the bolts like that. I cleaned everything. I took out my carpets, cleaned everything. Repaint at some rough spot if you have to. Like, I painted at some rough spots. It has some rusted spots. So I spray painted with, you know, white. Kind of clean everything. So I can see dirt, you know, when it comes in clearly than if you have a carpet, because carpet will smell too. So that's why I really take out all the carpets. But like the seats, when you clean it, you know, I don't know if I show you a video of cleaning it, but just buy some from Walmart, some can, they have a brush with it, some can foam, they have foam soap in it, detergent, just spray in it and use the brush that come with the can, and you know, spray on the carpet of the seat and then just scrub it, okay? Once white bubbles, or after you spray it, leave it on for like a minute or two and then just scrape it. Scrape all the dirt out. You see if there's some dirt spot, just scrape it out like I did. I finished my seats already. I think I need to scrape this part right here on the back. But I scraped everything on here already. It's pretty clean, you know. Just some spots not clean because it's molded. But I need to clean in the back seats here. Like in the back, you see? Yeah, this front right here, it's been clean. So, yeah, I don't think I need to show you that can. You should already know. Just go to Walmart or any auto part store and get you a can form of carpet cleaner. That's what it's called in the waxing cleaning section. Okay. So I need to find me a radio soon. So I need to install a radio. And installing these panels right here, I'll show you after I install those panels in place, and everything should be fine. I still would need to take out this odometer to replace the odometer, or you know, find out what's wrong with it, why my odometer is not jumping or running. But I probably have to replace the speed sensor for my odometer to work. That's what I heard. So I have to either replace this or the speed sensor from the transmission. And my car will be rock and roll, you know, everything is done. I'm not gonna put carpet, so I might put some metal piece on underneath my seats. So I put my foot down there at the metal bar, you know, like a metal plate. Yeah. And just pretty much gotta install, you know, little things like the side panel right here in place, but my body kit pretty much installed it. I just gotta seal up some spot with the bondo or sealant, I guess. And the only thing is my body front body kit is still out, so that's the last thing. Oh yeah, might as well I'm here and just talk about this here. Well, this guy, what I bought, I think he installed the body kit, and he painted black. Even the taillight was black. I have to do some sanding, so now it's kind of red on my taillight, or it was black, okay? But I still need to paint on that side because it's black. You know, he painted black for some reason. I don't know. That's kind of stupid, but I guess he's trying to make it foggy taillight. But he painted my reverse light also. You can see it's black. It should be clear white, you know, or dull white. But he forgot to install the reverse light, you see? These are the connection, and he just tied the connection up here and hide it. And he didn't install it, you know, until the reverse light. So one day I was trying to test it. I was like, what happened? I thought, you know, the reverse light gonna work too, you know, because everything else is working. And I find out kind of underneath and look and touch, there's no, you know, there's no reverse light connection. There's this part was gone. There's none of this. It's just this plug was there. That's it. The plug was there, but this part and the bolt, they don't have it. Just the cover. That's it. So I went to the junkyard and get these two connection again. It's from the same model. You gotta get it from the same model. And anyway, I got it for like $1 or so. It's pretty cheap, you know. But anyway, and I cleaned the connector with QD electric spray, clean all the connectors, and air blow it, and then plug it in. Voila! Turn on my engine, and these lights is on, is working right now, and I'm ready to install it back onto my reverse light cover there. So that's about it, and I'll show you guys after I finish it. Everything is done. Then another thing is I need the weather strip to be installed right here. This guy installed the body kit, and you know, there's a gap, and he didn't put weather strip there, but I need to buy weather strip. I need a lot of weather strip around my car because there's a lot of spot that need weather strip, just like here. There's some gaps, so I need weather strip. This trunk is not closed all the way down. I just don't want to close it because it's had a little problem, because if it's, you know, it had been hit dent right here. I gotta pull it out too. Yeah, but yeah, I didn't close it all the way down, but if I do, it still have a little gap, so I want to have weather strip to cover that gaps up. But anyways, I always have my car out, you know, especially in the summertime. I have it all out, but close the hood when the sun comes, because you don't want the sun get into the wreck of your battery or your engine. So close up the hood when the sun's coming up. That's how I do it. Yeah, I still gotta work with my tail lights to clean it and polish it. But my front one is pretty good now. It's shiny. Alright guys, this video is like 25 minutes already. It takes a really long time for me to just go over my door, the door hinge here. Yeah guys, I'm gonna have to let you go now. So before I go talk all day about my car, I'll make another videos on something, whatever I do, to let you guys see and check it out, okay? Whenever I get around to it. So just stick around with me, alright? Thanks for watching my channel, Auto Modifying Sport Channel. It's me, Young Leo Akil. It's signing out. Bye guys. Please subscribe, likes, and comments. Leave comments.